Glad in it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. This is the day that he has made. David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Praise the Lord. My feet shall stand within thy gates. Let's all stand, if we will, find Psalms 34 in your Bible. A psalm when David was running for his life, and things were very contrary, and he found himself in a fix, and what will I do when my back's up against the wall, and the enemy's trying to kill me, what would be in my mouth, what would be my expressions? Let's read a few of these verses David said there. He says, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continue to be in my mouth. My soul shall make a boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all my fears. They looked unto him, and were lightened. Their faces were not ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all his troubles. Let's just jump to verse 8. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Hallelujah. What does it say? Blessed is the man that trusts in him. How many have your trust in him today? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. This poor man cried. Save him out of all of his troubles. Hallelujah. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Oh, trust him. See if he's good. Hallelujah. Call on him. See if he'll answer. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Declare his wonders. Hallelujah. Let someone else hear. See if he'll get glad. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Glory to your name. Hallelujah. We bless you at all times in your praises. We make our boast in you. We say you are a good God. You're a great God. There's not another like you in all of the earth. None can heal, none can deliver like my God. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father, for all of your loving kindness and your tender mercies. Bless us today. We welcome you, your presence in this place today. We give you all the praise and glory. In Jesus' name, let the church say amen.
This is the day. Yeah. instructions as to how he wanted his tabernacle built and how he wanted Moses to give the people of Israel and Aaron and his sons his instructions. Hallelujah. So that there wouldn't be any question as to who their God was and to whom, hallelujah, they served. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Bible tells us, honey, that as God gave every intricate detail of instruction to Moses, he relayed those instructions to Aaron and to his sons. Because you see, there could not be any failure, any fault. Hallelujah. Because they had to go before the Father. Hallelujah. On the behalf of the sins of the people. And he told them how he wanted them, hallelujah, to anoint themselves, how to claim themselves before they entered into the tabernacle. Because you see, if they were not obedient to those instructions, they could very well lose their lives. Hallelujah. The bottom line says this morning, what I got out of that passage is that if we don't be obedient to God's word, hallelujah, we will not obey his instructions. Hallelujah. There will be consequences that we will have to make. Maybe, hallelujah, even our lives. So we cannot take it lightly, even when we come to his tabernacle here at Northside Christian Center, 844 East 46th Street North. Let's not take it lightly, because you see, this is God's tabernacle. This is God's building, even though it's a tabernacle made with hands. We serve the God Almighty. Let's not take our lives lightly and our walk with the Lord. I just wanted to leave those words with you this